Howdy, I'm Megan Clayton with Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service. Approximately 95% of Texas is privately owned, and these lands are managed by owners with different operations and goals. For both livestock and wildlife managers, the major focus of their operation should be the condition and health of their plant communities. Productivity of the plant communities depends on the management factors impacting these plants. While landowners can't control how much rain they get, they can control how their land responds to rainfall by conducting good habitat monitoring and management practices. Monitoring is the practice of evaluating plants over time to judge how the past land management is affecting the plant, soil, and water resources of the land. Landowners can monitor by conducting habitat management techniques or by simply observing changes in the land over time. Monitoring primarily looks at the extent of vegetative cover, which is the amount of land area covered by plant material. Being able to see how the range condition changes over time will allow landowners to make management decisions that are best for the land. Examples of habitat monitoring include maintaining precipitation records, photo points, and grazing exclosures. No matter which plant measurement methods you choose for your property, precipitation records should be collected year-round. It's best to install a rain gauge in each pasture or field if possible and record rainfall amounts in a notebook or computer spreadsheet. Rainfall records will help determine if changes in plant communities are caused by recent rainfall patterns or land management practices. Also, knowing whether you are falling short of average rainfall will aid in making proactive decisions that will benefit the land, such as reducing or removing livestock at the onset of drought conditions. Photo points provide an inexpensive and fast method for monitoring range condition. Photo points are permanent locations from which periodic photos are taken to evaluate general land changes over time. Photo points are easily established by driving a steel T-post or rebar into the ground. While standing at this T-post, begin recording whether grasses, forbs, woody plants, or bare ground dominate the area. If you know certain plant species, be sure to record that as well. Also note any obvious features to consider, such as the slope of the land. Another simple idea is to mark the T-post at ground level with spray paint so you can note if soil erosion occurs from year to year. These measurements and notes should be recorded on an annual basis. Be sure to mark the date and location for each photo. There are two types of photos that can be taken annually, landscape and ground level. Landscape photos are taken by facing each cardinal direction at the photo point on the same day each year, or at the very least in the same month. Landscape photos will show broad vegetation changes, such as brush encroachment, that may be occurring on the land. For ground level photos, use a hula hoop or a 3-foot by 3-foot square frame out of PVC pipe and place it on the ground at least 10 feet from the photo point. Mark the corners by driving rebar into two opposite corners of the frame or hula hoop so that the exact location can be found each time. Several of these can be established around each photo point. Take photos from above the plot looking straight down and record the plant cover and density, percent litter, and percent bare ground for each plot photo. Grazing exclosures are cages made of welded wire panels and T-posts that landowners can use to evaluate the condition of the area by excluding livestock and/or wildlife from grazing a small, representative area. By comparing vegetation inside and outside of the cage, the landowner can determine how grazing is affecting species composition and overall plant growth. Exclosures can be built using steel T-posts and 4-foot-tall, 4-inch by 4-inch welded wire panels. Install the T-posts so that they are a square or a triangle, and then attach the panels to the post with baling wire or another high-strength wire. Exclosures should contain a minimum of 4 square feet, but can be bigger depending on cost and preference. At least once a year, take photos or detailed notes to compare the plant species present and the amount of area they cover. Land managers should aim for the highest level of range condition possible, as it could improve land productivity by reducing erosion, increasing rainfall infiltration, slowing the rate of invasion of undesirable species, and allow faster recovery after drought. One can evaluate success of a habitat management project by monitoring wildlife populations or livestock body conditions, but without understanding the reasons why they are increasing or decreasing, a land manager can't make informed decisions for future management. Therefore, monitoring plant communities will provide more definitive results. When developing a monitoring and management program, it's best to use the techniques that fit your specific land management goals.